$1 billion ambition.
Now we about to go into the history of the whole Jay-Z and Nas shit, and what the truth is, and what the facts is. I'm signing off.
My first album had no famous guest appearances. The outcome, I'm crowned the best services.
Nas is in the class by himself, because he's the birth of all of this coming in. Big, Hov, Us, Mobb Deep, Wu, everyone.
You put it like this, man. I've been doing this since 91 on Main Source. This is the
streets disciple. My raps are trifle. I shoot slugs from my brain just like a rifle. Stampede the stage. I leave the microphone split. Play Mr. Tuffy while I'm on some pretty tone shit. Verbal assassin. My architect pleases. When I was 12, I went to hell for snuffing Jesus. Nasty Nas is a rebel to America. Police murderer. I'm causing hysteria.
Super big fans of Nas. You know, because Nas came out a year before us.
I smoke all the mic like smoking Joe Frazier, the Hellraiser. Raising hell with the flavor. Terrorize the jam like troops in Pakistan. Swinging through your town like your neighborhood spy.
And me and Ghost had an eye on him because it was like, yo, we always about New York rap niggas anyway. It's like, if you got it, you got it. We seen something in this kid at a young time, and we kind of felt like we knew him. Me, why I really liked him is not only because he was clever, but me and him wore the same hats.
The frame in half with the thoughts that bomb shit like math. So if you want to try to flip, go flip on the next man.
He wore the camouflage hat and he wore the fedora. I call those hats years of experience hats. So I had those same two hats on in Protect Your Neck. And he had those same two hats on when he did the song Halftime.
Before a blunt, I take out my front, then I start the front. Matter of fact, I'll be on a manhunt. You couldn't catch me in the streets without a ton of reefer. That's like Malcolm X catching a jungle fever. King poetic, too much flavor, I'm major. Atlanta ain't braver, I pull a number like a pager.
Illmatic is the birth of the next generation golden MC. So we can never take that from him, because Illmatic is what kicked in the door to make a lot of us even think that this is capable. He was the combination of Coogee Rap, Kane, KRS-One.
You're too smart, man.
You know what I'm saying?
You're too smart.
All formulated in one.
Yo, Illmatic is one of my best albums ever. Ever. Like, he's down with the Rakims, the KRS, the G-Raps, and the Kanes, and the Bizz, and you know what I mean? All that shit. Slick Rick and them.
The Brooklyn's Marcy Projects Jay-Z versus the poet of Queensbridge Nas. Oh, it's a battle that's the latest in the tried and true tradition of hip-hop, and as you're about to see, as competition often does, it brought out the best lyrically between Nas and Jay-Z.
I'm from where niggas pull your car and argue all day about who's the best MCs, Biggie, Jay-Z, and Nas.
Not positive who's the best, Pac, Nas, and Big.
What's going down with Jay-Z? Tell us all about that. What exactly is happening?
Did he cut to the chase or what? Basically, man.
I think we just need to get on with this, you know, to address this issue rather. Yeah, what's happening, bro?
I mean, you put it like this, man. I've been doing this since 91 on Main Source.
This is my man, the rapper Nas, Nasty
what
Nas.
Queensbridge, you know and I leave the microphone split. Play Mr. Tuffy while I'm on some pretty cold shit. Yeah. Verbal assassin, my architect pleases. When I was 12, I went to hell for stuffing Jesus.
Yeah. I got in the game with my first album, Illmatic.
The city never sleeps, full of villains and creeps. That's where I learned to do my hustle, had to scuffle with...
I dedicate Illmatic to my man Illmatic Ice, doing time for murder right now, cause he's a strong man and he made his own rules for the game and he ain't take nothing from nobody, and he was kinda like a strong path to follow and look at, even though he got caught up and misled into the wrong situation and now he's caught in the system right now. I still dedicated the album to him.
And it kind of influenced a lot of people because, you know, Jay used to rhyme with a fast skibbity dip style, you know.
But check out the J, check out the A, check out the Y, Z.
They had a really faster rhyme style, like more similar to the quick tongue rhyme style, which was really prominent in the early 90s.
You know, like with jazz and original flavors.
You want to fly style? Jay's about to show it.
Well, come.
Can I? It's never a question of how, but when I rip it, will I quit it, forget it? Still I always on point whenever I hit it. Writing's forbidden, don't do what y'all done it, too late, y'all did it. Now straight on the track, I'm burning your back like backdraft. Pros who follow the track, gotta stutter, that nigga's fast. I pick up the pieces, I straighten it out like D-Rock or C-S or pieces. It's your choice, Jesus Christ.
And when I knew him, I met him, he had backpacks on like a Decepticon and, you know, the whole nine yards, you know what I'm saying? He was a cool brother, and yo, though, I always felt it was a little tension, you know what I mean? And when he dropped his first album, my second album came out, it was written, you know what I'm saying? He's a real competitive brother that really wants to outsell people, and, you know, and I'm not into that. I'm like, you know, I'm just doing music, and he was really mad that his first album didn't outsell my second album, and they dropped the same time.
In July 1996, Nas's It Was Written debuted at number one on the Billboard 200 albums chart.
June 25th. 1996, Reasonable Doubt is released. About 7 or so years after he made his first rap video cameo in Jazz's Hawaiian Sophie, a couple years after his debut verse on Original Flavor's Can I Get Open, the extremely talented young man from Marcy got his chance to make his mark with his debut LP. And while I can't deny it made an impact, it did take the album 6 years to go platinum. To give you some perspective, All Eyes on Me went platinum in 4 hours. Hell, even Jay-Z himself had 4 of his own albums go platinum before Reasonable Doubt did.
I mean, he was really mad. And then he thought that the way to do it was throw on a tie and act like The Firm and shout out The Firm and put Foxy on records and do that. And you know what he had to do was just do him. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, but it started even back then. I would hear him say little things. And also, I can't just put it on him and make him a bad guy. You know what I'm saying? It's just the nature of hip hop. This is what it is. It's the battle of the minds. You know what I'm saying? He came up around Kane. I had my little time spinning around Rakim and Eric B and Lost Professor and Freddie Fox, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Back in the days at Power Play Studio. So I think the battle era just came back from where Rakim and Kane left it. They didn't. Rakim and Kane never battled. I think this is their battle.
Kane's battle kind of manifested itself on the generation after you with Nas and Jay-Z. And it's basically the same argument of the punchlines and the slick talk versus the kind of poetry. When you saw that battle unfold, how did you feel about that? Or did you even see yourself in that? Like, wow, that's like us all over again, the full circle.
And she actually, she Nas gave me a ring. Nas gave me a call. And he asked me, you know, what do I think he should do? A mutual friend that we had, a kid named Chuck. And, you know, he was telling me, you know, Chuck told me if I don't, you know, do such and such, it's over. And so, you know, I told him, I said, look, my brother. And speaking from what I knew with me and Kane and everybody else, I was like, look, Jay, I said, you know, I said, if you want to battle Jay-Z, I said, you got to do it because you want to do it. Not because I said you should do it, not because Chuck said you should do it, not because anybody said you should do it. Not, you know, sometimes even, you know, you got to mute your fans because, you know, fans, they want to see something. But, you know, you got to do what you feel. And I told him, I said, look, you know, if that's something that you want to do, that's, you know, that's your decision. I said, you can't let nobody else make that decision for you. And that was the Nas and Jay-Z beat. And, you know, Nas would tell you straight up, you know, that's what I told him, and that's how I felt.
You feel what I'm saying? So yeah. It's too many, it's a lot of meanings. You know, Jay claims to be the king of New York. I don't want to be the king of New York. The king of New York was B.I.G., period. Right. You know what I'm saying? So he threw a jab at me on the Summer Jam and Hot 97 Summer Jam because there was a lot of tension.
The long festering rivalry between Jay-Z's Rockefeller camp and QB's Finest blew up on stage when Jay debuted The Takeover.
He starts doing the Takeover. No one knew what that song was, all right? He does the first verse, The Takeover. You hear the background, the little Jim Morrison Doors sample.
Come on!
Don't put on door. Everyone's like, okay, but they're listening to him.
I don't care if you mob people, I hope rules. You little f- I got money stacks bigger than you.
He had the verse that dissed Prodigy. So he said that verse and tried to clown him and the crowd loved it.
But then at the end of the line he goes, ask Nas, he don't want it with Ho.
Ask Nas, he don't want it with Ho. No.
Crowd went crazy, like, whoa, wait a minute. Oh, it's like, okay, now it's on.
At that point, Jay-Z finally acknowledged that he doesn't like Nas, or there's a conflict with Nas, and he said it.
You know what I'm saying? So he just knew. We spoke in a party, and I told him that I didn't want it to come to this, and he did what he had to do regardless at the Summer Jam and when he did Prodigy and he said my name. Then I heard he had a song called Takeover, so I put out the freestyle, Stillmatic.
Hey, yo, Nasty Nas, what up? Ain't nothing, a lot of cowards frontin'. I hear what you saying, but yo, this is all love for me, you know? No doubt, smoke them cowards, it's still mad.
Boom. About 3 weeks later, Nas drops a beautiful freestyle called Stillmatic.
With the release of Stillmatic on mixtape, Nas took his argument back to the streets.
H to the Izzo, M to the Izzo, pushes on your phony, the rapper version of Cisco.
When Jay did the Summer Jam, you know, everybody's in the streets is like, yo, I know you're gonna get at him, so I got at him with the freestyle joint.
Your fake rhymes and no times I never took place, you liar. Un was your first court case, you had no prize.
He came out and capitalized off that with his album Takeover, with the song Takeover.
When Takeover was released on Jay's Blueprint album, his new verse responded to Stillmatic and made the opening blow at Summer Jam seem like a tap.
Had a spark when you started, but now you're just garbage. You fell from top 10 to not mention at all.
He comes at Nas hard from all angles. He comes at it from the perspective of, like, from a fan, kind of. Like, you know, like, your last album was, he broke it down, how Nas fell off.
If I was to get at somebody on that level, I gotta make sure I come with my best.
Now, you know what I'm saying, I had to speak my piece on this album with Ether, really addressing him, not like as a jokester, but as a man, you know what I'm saying? And after this, you know what I'm saying, I'm done. I felt I spoke my word. I am officially done with this. 10 years from now, I don't want people saying all Nas ever was the guy that was battling Jay-Z. I don't want to be having to name other rappers in my music ever again. I never did up until this point. If you listen to all Jay-Z albums, he mentions either my name, not dissing me, mentions either my name or makes references to one of my songs on each album. I don't want to name other rappers just to solidify my position as a king. That's not how I do it, you know what I'm saying?
There's one thing that he did borrow from the Queensbridge rapper. Who did Jay sample on his first hit, Dead Presidents? You guessed it, none other than Nas.
I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Say what?
I'm out for presidents to represent me.
That's not how I do it, you know what I'm saying? But he pulled me in it, and I did what I had to do, and I'm done with it. I don't like it. I love it for hip-hop, but outside of that, as a person, I like to make music, and I don't like talking about other rappers, yo. But I had to do what I had to do on this album right here. So that's what's up.
You been on my dick, nigga. You love my style, nigga.
I prove you lost already. Great.